What is that?
I have no idea, but I'm not going in there.
Is that our first guest?
There comes Marie. Let's enter in.
Excuse me, this fell on the floor. Let me just put it up here, guys. She is woman.
And hear me roar.
Okay, today we have a fantastic show. Dr. Lisa Masterson is here to talk about her rise to success in the face of adversity. It's very interesting. And Laura McKenzie is going to show us that not all vacations are about rest and relaxation. Oh, no, we're going to take a look at some of her recommendations for outdoor adventure trips. Really cool. And it'll kind of just get your blood flowing, you know, give you a new perspective on the word vacation. But right now, long before Michael Jackson became the king of pop, my first guest was the undisputable queen of 70s pop. She's, I'm telling you, a string of unforgettable hits like Ain't No Way to Treat a Lady, Delta Dawn, and I Am Woman. Yes. And with a Grammy to go with it, boy, I'll tell you. However, in 2002, she disappeared from the public eye, and she went home to Australia in search of a normal life. Well, she vowed that her days of performing were done. They were all over, but the world could not forget her songs or her undeniable voice, just amazing voice. And the fans have coaxed her back to the spotlight. She is the woman, let me tell you. Come on, let's all roar for Helen Reddy! How are you?
Oh, it's so good to see you.
It's been forever. Helen Reddy! Breaking up. Oh, my gosh, look at you. It has been so long since I've seen you.
Yes, you were just a little girl, I think.
Not that little. But my mom loved you.
Yeah, well, I loved your mom. She was great.
She did, you guys, she got you into genealogy, right?
Well, I was always into genealogy, but she sort of opened up a lot of doors for me, which was great. Yeah,
she just adored you. Oh, my gosh, I'm so glad you're back out of retirement.
Me too.
Okay, so I'm going to ask you some questions that I know you've been asked a million times.
Okay.
But we have a whole new generation of people that know your music, mm-hmm. and they want to know about your life. Mm-hmm. And it's like people will say to me, you know, you recorded Paper Roses, my first song, but I Am Woman. What a song. Classic, classic song. Did you know when... Now, you wrote that song, right?
I wrote the words, yes.
Yes. Did you know that it was going to be such a mega hit and become the theme song for the women's movement?
Had I had even the slightest inkling that that was going to happen, I would have been too... I would have been lacking in confidence. I wouldn't have been able to actually do it, I don't
really?
Think. Yeah.
So you just... Where did it come from? Where did the whole idea directly...
Well, I'd been involved with the women's movement for about 9 or 10 months at the time. And I was very gung-ho for that. And when I looked at the songs that were written for women, you know, they were like, there was this terrible song in the 1960s called Born a Woman. If you're born a woman, you're born to be lied to, cheated on, and treated like dirt. But when your man comes home, you're glad it happens that way, because to be his woman, no price is too great to pay.
Oh, yuck.
Now, young girls were being indoctrinated with that nonsense.
It is nonsense.
So I said to myself, I have got to do something about this. And so I sat down and wrote I Am Woman.
So when did you realize that the song was taking off and it was becoming as big as it was?
Well, it didn't take off at first. at first, Marie. In fact, I used to go around the country talking to different DJs and program managers,
yeah.
And some of them would say, oh, I can't stand that song, but it's a funny thing, you know, my wife loves it. And it was actually because I couldn't get any radio airplay, so I went on 19 different TV shows. There were a lot of them in those days.
Yeah.
And sang I Am Woman over and over again. And finally, women were calling up radio stations and requesting airplay. So thank you, ladies, everywhere.
Wow. So, see, that was back in the day when radio, when you could actually go around and get them to play it. Now they just have it all computerized and they tell you what you're going to listen to. I miss those days of radio. Where you could do it that way. So you have sung that song millions and millions and millions and millions of times.
Well, more than once, yes.
Yes. So funny. Do you ever, you know, people have said it, do you get tired of singing it?
Not really. But, you know, you've worked in Vegas too. So you know what it's like, two shows a night, seven nights a week. You reach a point where you're thinking about wallpaper. But otherwise, I'm fully focused.
The reason I say that too is looking at your life, my life, you were born into singing. You were born into show business.
I was born into a show business family.
Yeah.
Yes.
Do you ever just stop and think, you know I do this. I've done it my whole life. You do something that long, you become good at it. Is this what you love?
Well, it's the only thing I know how to do pretty much.
Not true.
But I mean, it started out when I think I was 5.
Mm-hmm.
And, excuse me, my parents were in vaudeville, and I was the plant in the audience. And my father would say, is there a little boy or girl down there somewhere who'd like to come up and talk to me? And, of course, I'd be up like a shot, you
right.
know? And we'd talk for a little while, and I'd sing a song, at the end of which he'd say, you've never seen me before, have you, little girl? And I'd say, no, Daddy. And then off into the wings where my mother was waiting with open arms.
So vaudeville. Isn't
it
fabulous?
Totally.
Mm. See, I grew up on the tail end of that, too.
Uh-huh.
But, you know, it's an interesting question because I started at 3, and you go, my gosh, do I do this because I love it or because I just don't know anything else?
Exactly. That's it. The latter is for me.
But do you love it?
Do I love it? I love every second I'm on stage.
Yeah. Yeah, it's fun.
Yeah.
I'm so glad you're back on stage.
Me too.
Now, why with all of that did you decide in 2002 to just say, I'm going to walk away from all of it? That is fascinating that you would do that.
Can I be truthful?
Absolutely.
If I had to sing Leave Me Alone one more time... I mean, you've heard that song, haven't you? Leave me alone, leave me alone, leave me alone.
Leave me alone, leave me alone. Oh, leave me alone, leave me alone.
Oh, leave me alone, 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 leave me. And trust me, the songwriter was not up all night with that one.
But it was a huge hit.
Yes, it was.
What did it get in women's hearts? Leave me alone.
Leave me alone, yes. Well, I think that point was pretty much made in the chorus, yes.
So... You know what, I think it's very brave of you to just draw a line and say, I'm starting a new life. I'm going to go out there and see what was out there that I missed. What have you found? What have you discovered? Was it hard to go to a new life?
Well, I went back to college and got a degree in clinical hypnotherapy.
You did?
Which was something that interested me, yes, always has interested me.
From the time when?
Oh, I think I did my first past life regression when I was about... 17.
Really?
Mm. Mm.
And so you went, how long did you study for that?
I don't know that I did. It was just stuff that just came up and out.
Now have you done some fantastic regressions and things like that?
I've had some very interesting things happen.
Do you help people or just yourself?
No. I help people.
Can you regress me a little?
I can, but not on television.
You're so cute.
We need time and space.
We need a lot of time. There's
yes.
not much space.
Oh,
no.
I disagree.
So, I think that's so interesting. One of the things that I was reading, because, you know, I've known you a long time, but I haven't seen you for a while, and you describe yourself as being a deep thinker. What kind of things do you like to think and dwell on and ponder?
Well, what's it all about?
Alfie?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, because there are so many layers and layers and layers and layers, and the deeper you get, the more interesting it becomes.
So what are some of the things you've discovered?
Well, definitely I believe that life is eternal.
Oh, I do.
Yeah. And I think we're in a good time in history. I think we are going through a lot of very positive changes.
Is that necessary? Do you think things have to get shaken up to get back on track?
Oh, yes. Always.
Kind of the circle of life, huh?
Yeah, that's a good way of putting it.
Yeah. So have you found peace?
Have I found peace?
Yeah.
Yes, oh, yes.
You
look happy.
A
long time since. Yeah, I am.
I'm so glad.
Yeah.
Is there anybody in your life?
No. That's the best part.
So no boyfriend, no.
Oh no.
Not interested.
No, I've got a cat. And she's lovely because she never argues with me.
You're so cute.
Yeah.
Cats are very peaceful.
Yes, they are.
Yes.
She's a little sweetheart.
Wow. Okay, so, you know, I mentioned I'm so glad that you're coming back to stage and that you found this, you know, eternal peace. But I'll tell you, your voice brings peace to so many people. I was telling her right before the show, there are certain people that you'll say, oh, Adele sounds like so-and-so or whatever sounds like so. Nobody sounds like you. Nobody.
Thank you.
Come on. Nobody. I'm serious. You're the best. So now let's... I could talk to you all day. I just think you're fascinating. But what was the catalyst? What was the decision in saying, I want to go back and perform?
It was my sister's 80th birthday. And she asked me if I would sing a duet with her. Well, you know, you don't say no to your older sister, do you? And
I'd like to say no to my older brother.
Oh. Anyway, so we're singing the duet, and we've got mics, and there's monitors, and I heard my voice for the first time in 10 years.
You never sang?
No, I didn't sing at all.
For 10 years?
For 10 years, and then I thought, that doesn't sound too bad. I think I should do that again.
Was it surprising to you?
Well, I just... There was enough time had passed. Like I said, I was never going to sing Leave Me Alone ever again. I mean, I was tired of singing all those same hits.
Right.
And I wanted to sing more of the songs that I love and have always loved, the blues and those kind of things.
Right.
So I'm enjoying singing now as opposed to the pop stuff.
Is it different now? Is it different? Do you have a different passion for it?
Yes, I do. I do. I'm loving every minute up there.
I have to come see your show.
I wish you would.
So and you know what? I'm so excited because later in the show, you are going to sing for us. Is that so cool? Okay, you have to stick around. And because for the first time on television since your return, this is the first time you've sung on television.
By God,
I am so excited, you guys. The best. So, thank you for being here. I adore you. Please, I want to come see your show. Okay. We'll give all the information of where people can go. And we'll be right back with Dr. Lisa Masterson.
Thank you for having me.
You're darling. Oh, you're so good. Okay, we are so happy to have Helen Reddy back performing for everybody and to be performing first time on TV since her return right here on the Marie stage. I'm so honored, Helen, so honored. Singing her classic, You and Me Against the World. What a gorgeous song. Please welcome Helen Reddy.
Sometimes it feels like you and me against the world. When all the others turn their backs and walk away, you can count on me to stay. Remember when the circus came to town? By the
clown. Wasn't it nice to be around someone that you knew? Someone who was big and strong and looking out for you and me against the world. Sometimes it feels like you and me against the world. And for all the times we've cried, I always felt that God was on our side. And when one of us is gone, and one of us is left to carry on, then remembering we'll have to do our memories alone will get us through. Think about the days of me and you, you and me against the
You said that you don't want to sing songs that you've sung a million times before.
Right.
Why this song? What is the connection to this song?
Oh, this song is a beautiful song. It's a Paul Williams song. It was originally written as a man-woman love song, and I changed it to a mother-child love song.
Aww.
And it is a beautiful song.
Did you see they were crying out there? They were just like, oh my gosh. And when you started, I saw women out there going, oh, I've got chills. So did you notice any difference in your voice?
Well, it's in the same register. That's the thing that amazes me.
You have no idea how amazing that is to be able to do that. That's a one-of-a-kind voice. I don't sing in the same that I used to.
No.
Of course, I was four. No, I'm kidding. So, do you feel different now that you're out here singing and you see they love you? How does it make you feel?
Happy but older.
No, never. Classic.
Okay.
Classic right. Beauty. Gorgeous. You're so great.
Thank you, darling.
You know what? I'm so honored that you would sing here, Helen. Don't go away. We'll be right back. Helen Reddy. We're ready for you, Helen.
Coming up, a final thought with Marie.
Lisa Masterson, Lauren McKenzie, and of course, Helen Reddy. Helen, what's next for you? Where are you touring?
Oh, I won't be touring until the summer now.
Uh-huh.
But it'll be check out my website, helenreddy.com.
Woo!
Do you know what? Can I tell you something? This is why I wanted to do this show. I wanted you to be able to meet the music icons that I got to grow up with. And it's such an honor to have you here today. I hope you guys have had as much fun as I have. Oh my gosh. Thank you so much for being on the show. Bye for now.